expectation would be for two 25 basis point rate increases in 2017, which is really unchanged from where we've been since the middle of last year. What has changed would be the timing of those rate moves. We were originally considering something that was more like June and December for those rate increases in 2017, and I would say now are more in line with what would be a March and a September expectation, which would leave then a little wiggle room at the end of the year if we continue to see a need for increasing rates at that point. I think at this point, with rates above the abysmal level, the expectation would be that we start to see some cash flow back in from an industry standpoint. The industry, from an asset standpoint, has been very steady around $2.7 trillion for the last several years. And the expectation would be that with increasing rates and overall higher yields and spreads, that you would see government products continue to do well from a cash flow perspective, but perhaps prime and muni products that have been disenchanted from a usership standpoint because of money market reform maybe gain a little traction just simply because their spread is a little bit more attractive at this point. Well, given that the Fed is an independent entity, we do think that they will continue their independence throughout 2017, but obviously they have to coexist and work productively with the current administration. So, given that the Trump presidency will likely involve a little bit more stimulus and a little bit higher growth from a GDP perspective, and with that, a little bit higher inflation, what we think is in store is a Fed that becomes a little bit more cautious. The Fed has certainly been very accommodative over the course of the last several years, and we do think that there will be more caution that is brought into the picture from a Fed standpoint for 2017.